So my Prakash Govindan Prabhu, can you please unmute Rajiv Gautam Prabhu, the first house. So Rajiv Gautam Prabhu has collected both Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita, and he is the one who is associated with Gita Reading Society here in Singapore. We have three temples, Gita Reading Society in the center, Gauranga Center. We have Asukesari and we have Sengkang. So Rajiv Gautam Prabhu is like mostly associated with the Gita Reading Society, and then he coordinates, he and you know, Mataji, everybody, they coordinate the, you know, weekend, Saturday evening prasadam service, and then a lot of other stuff to Rajiv Gautam Prabhu and family.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
So Rajiv Gautam Prabhu, you are in Singapore how many years?
It has been around 12 plus years in Singapore.
Okay, how many children you have?
He's my son. So he has been studying in Singapore from since childhood, and we are here almost 12 plus years. So we have been visiting Gita Reading Society, and with mercy of Devkinandan Prabhu and his teachings, we are able to realize some of our meaning of our life. And we hope with this book reading, and you know, we should be able to inculcate some values, and we can inculcate these values in our practical daily life.
Wonderful. So you are taking Bhagavatam or Chaitanya Charitamrita?
I've taken both sets, Prabhuji.
Oh, wonderful. You have both of them. Very nice. Yeah. I can see your altar.
Yes, Prabhuji. This is the book table I have.
Here is the book table. Okay. Yes, Prabhuji. Yeah. So I will say a few words from the Srimad Bhagavatam for you. What's your son's name?
Vishu. Hemang Dubey.
Vishu. Okay. So... very nice that you have taken both Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita. Very wonderful. Actually, as I was telling in the talk also today, Bhagavatam says that in all of us, there is an angel in us, there is an animal in us. And which one we will bring out depends on which one we feed. Like you see, when Dhruva Maharaj was dealing with his stepmother, she brought the worst out of Dhruva. Suruchi, by speaking certain things to him, and you know, the very angry propensity came out of Dhruva. His lips were quivering, body was trembling and all that. Eyes were filled with tears and bloodshot and all that. But when he went to his mother Suniti, she brought the best out of Dhruva by sending him to Lord Vishnu. And by focusing on Lord Vishnu, his life became very glorious, like a bit of, like a garden full of roses, you see. So which means one mother brought worst out of him, another mother brought the best out of him. So then what was in Dhruva? Was Dhruva having best or worst? If you see, both were there in Dhruva, but his own mother Suniti brought the best out of Dhruva. Similarly, in our life, when we study Srimad Bhagavatam, it will teach us how to bring the best out of others, how to bring best out of your son, how to bring best out of your wife, how to bring the best out of your colleagues in the office, how to bring best out of the people with whom you interact regularly. So the Bhagavatam will give us scripts to live, how to lead our life. And bringing the best out of somebody actually means inspiring them to come closer to Krishna. Just like Suniti told Dhruva that, my dear boy, my being your mother is not helping you. I'm not able to solve your problem, but Lord Krishna can give you love of a million mothers. So go to forest and meet him. So all of us, we can bring the best out in others by bringing them close to Krishna's lotus feet. And when they delight in Krishna's lotus feet, they will be very grateful to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For taking Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita. Read it nicely. I'll pray that, you know, Krishna and Guru bless you. And this reading of this is enlightening to you, and you are able to benefit yourself in your life and benefit others.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.